It's just, all right. Bible says in St. John chapter 11, verse 25, Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me. Thank God this morning that we believe in Jesus. How many believes in Jesus this Amen. Morning? Thank God we believe in him this morning. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? Church, we have to believe that. I'm going to preach on this morning because of his resurrection. I thank God, church, that he was resurrected. He was a supreme sacrifice, a sacrifice that was accepted of God. Could you imagine where we'd be this morning if Jesus hadn't been that perfect lamb, a lamb without spot or blemish, and on that third day he was resurrected? I thank God for that, church, because you know what? Because of his resurrection, we don't have no sin, because he come and washed our sins away. And we have life. This morning, God has resurrected us from death unto life. I'm talking about spiritually this morning. Church, at one time we were dead. One time we were without God. One time we were without all the covenant promises of God. But thank God this morning, because of Jesus and his resurrection power, we have life this morning. And the Bible says in him we live and move and have our being. I thank God this morning, church, that he has made us alive. He's made us the place that we can live in heavenly place and have fellowship with God. Because, church, at one time we were without God. Could you imagine what we went through with before we had God? And could you imagine this morning that our way we go through life is, and all the things that have happened this morning, that not to have God with us? I thank God he's overshadowed us this morning. And the Bible said, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I mean, church, we are shadowed by his love, his protection, his promise, his provision. I thank God that because we are alive in him, he's obligated. I said he is obligated, amen, to watch over us because we're his children and we have life. Thank God, church, he's raising us from a spiritual death unto a lively hope this morning. And thank God we can, amen, live with God, have blessings of God. And I thank God for that this morning. Because of his resurrection. Because the devil couldn't hold him down. Because the grave couldn't hold him down. Thank God that the devil can't hold us there. Thank God for that. And because we have that same spirit, amen, that raised Jesus from the dead, we have that same spirit living in us. And the Bible says, greater is he that's in us than he that's in the world. Thank God we've got something in us this morning, church, amen, that the devil can't do nothing about. We have life, everlasting life. I'm talking about a life, amen, not only in this life, but the next life to come. Glory to God. And church, I believe sometimes we don't recognize what it meant for Jesus to be resurrected, because if he had been resurrected, the Bible said we'd still be in our sin. And it's amazing why a lot of people today don't believe in the resurrection, don't accept the resurrection. But church, I thank God this morning we have accepted the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And the Bible said because we believe that he was resurrected, and because we believe in him, praise God, that we have life. Glory to God. And I thank God for that. One time I was dead, but thank God I'm alive. And one time I was blind, thank God now I can see. Thank God, amen, that I had no power with myself. I couldn't overcome myself. How many knows what I'm talking about this morning? I tried to do good. How many have tried to do good before they got saved? You know what, church? I learned I was a failure, but thank God when I give my heart to Jesus, glory to God, like the Spirit of life come in me, glory to God, and I had power over the devil, glory to God. Give the Lord a hand clap this morning, church. Glory to God. And church, not only that, the Bible tells us because of his resurrection power, amen, he defeated the devil on Calvary. Amen. He defeated the devil out of death. And because he defeated the devil, amen, we can defeat the devil. And this is what Jesus was talking about. He said, amen, he said, when I go away, amen, I'm gonna give you power. I'm going to give you the keys, praise God. And church, I thank God for the power, the keys that he's given us, praise God. Because the Bible says, Jesus said to the disciples, I give you power over all of your enemies. The Bible says in Luke chapter 10, verse 9, verse 19. Behold, I give you power, or give unto you power, to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. Thank God, he said nothing by any means will hurt you. And church, I believe with all my heart, we should take that word to our heart tonight, this morning, church, because I tell you, the devil likes to threaten us, and the devil likes to make us think that he has power over us. The devil does not have power over you. In fact, Jesus gave us power not only to rebuke him, but we can put him under our feet. And I thank God this morning, amen, when the devil comes at us, we can rebuke him, but we've got to realize, because we believe in Jesus, and we've been sealed by the Holy Spirit, that the devil can't do nothing with us, because Jesus has empowered us, and we have that, like I said, we have that same spirit, amen, that raised Jesus up. We have it living in us, and don't let the devil try to tell you that he's got power over you, because he is already defeated, he's already beat, and Jesus said, I give you power. If you are a child of God this morning, and you believe in Jesus Christ this morning, and you have Jesus living in you, don't let no demons or no devil or anything else cause you to have unbelief or doubt. My God can do anything, like that song we saw a while ago. My God is all powerful. He's a great I am. He's everything to us because of Jesus Christ, and because he was resurrected, and if we are sealed with was justified, that was taken away from us when we believed in Jesus, and now Jesus is sitting on the right hand side of the Father, making intercession for us, not just because for our sin. Thank God, he's sitting there and making intercession for our sin, but he's making intercession when the devil comes and try to come before the throne and smear us and cause the, try to, and it causes the things that happen to us. But church, I'm here to tell you, he's there to take up for us. If we're sick, he's there, amen, to be our healer. If we need a deliverance, he's there to deliver us. Thank God he's sitting there, amen, and being able to deliver us because he lives forevermore. Amen. He said he's the high priest and he lives forevermore. And thank God for that this morning, church, because of his resurrection, we have power over the devil. And Jesus said, I give you power over the devil. That's why, because we have Jesus living in us and we have that resurrection power in us, that before we didn't have no power. But church, when we got saved, we've got the power to rebuke the devil, stand on God's word, and believe God's word, and don't let the devil creep in. The Bible says the devil's job, amen, when the word comes, when God gives us a word through preaching or through a prophecy or whatever, we need to take that word and don't let the devil take it from us. Because church, God gives us a word of healing, we need to grab a hold of it. If God gives us a word of deliverance, we need to grab a hold of it. Because church, that resurrection power, he's given us power over the devil, amen, to rebuke him. The Bible said that he goes to and fro like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. But thank God, Jesus has given us a power through faith that we can rebuke him. I said, I thank God this morning because of his resurrection power, and because we believe in him, church, we have that resurrection power because of the faith that we have in Jesus, and he's given us that power that we can give a Lord a hand. Oh, we can rebuke the devil this morning. Too many people sit around and listen to him and let the devil take the word right from us. Amen. But church, let me tell you something. I thank God this morning we got enough word in us, enough faith in us. Amen. When the devil comes, we know that it's him. I said, we know that it's him, praise God, and we can learn to rebuke him, glory to God.
Amen.
Not only that, but I thank God for his hope this morning.
Yes.
We didn't have no hope. I said, we didn't have no hope, church, but thank God we've got a hope not only in this life. The Bible says that if we have Jesus, it's just in this life, we have no hope. We're being most miserable. But because we have Jesus in this life, we could have amen, hope in the next life. What are you trying to say, Brother Magnus? I don't know about you, but I got hope this morning because I'm listening, amen. I'm not looking for an undertaker. I'm looking for the upper taker. I'm looking for that sale, praise God. Amen. When Jesus comes, the Bible tells us, in fact, let me read that this morning. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. See, a lot of people don't have hope, but we do. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brother, concerning them which are asleep, of those that have already died and went on to heaven, church. I thank God, church, that when we die, amen, our spirit is given to God and our soul is given back to God. And church, well, I think we're up in heaven rejoicing and being glad. But we have a hope this morning, church. The world doesn't have a hope. These people that don't believe in Jesus and don't have Jesus, they have no hope. But church, thank God, we as a church and born again believers and believe in the resurrection of Jesus, we have a hope this morning, praise God. All we have to do is stand and believe in Jesus. The same power that raised up Jesus is going to be the same power that's going to raise up those people, amen, in the spirit that has already died. This is what the Bible says, verse 14. For if we believe, let me go back a bit. The Bible says, concerning them which are asleep, that you sorrow not. Thank God, church, we don't have to have sorrow in our life. I know we have a sorrow that we cry and we weep because of our loved one that's had passed on. I mean, the Bible expects that. It tells us we have a right to repeat or to weep because, church, if Jesus wept and met at the tomb, it gives us a right also to weep. And I'm talking about, church, of people that weep that has no hope. Thank God, church, when we see people, amen, that's died in Jesus Christ, we have a hope that they have a hope, and we can preach hope to them. Amen. One day we're going to see them. Because of his resurrection power, we have a hope this morning that for loved ones that passed on, we can see them. And I'm looking forward to that. Can I hear an amen? Amen. But there's some that don't have no hope. But we believe in Jesus Christ, we have a hope. Amen. Verse 14 says, but if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain to the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. Now what he's saying is, church, when Jesus comes back, they're going to be the first one that's going to be resurrected. The Bible said the dead in Christ shall rise first. So if you've got a look, wouldn't it be nice to be at a graveyard with your loved ones? Now, church, most of us are buried up there. Your mind is buried. Wouldn't it be nice if wherever your loved ones are buried, be out there giving, put flowers on the grave or something, and only once, praise God, you'll hear a sound. I mean, it'd be a quick sound. And church, let me tell you something. I thank God. Wouldn't that be nice to see the dead begin to rise up? And the Bible said the dead shall rise up first, and we which are alive and remain shall be called up together. Glory to God, church. We're all going to go together to be with Jesus. Glory to God. Because of his resurrection power. Don't let nobody tell you that you don't have to believe in the resurrection. The Bible says if we don't believe in the resurrection and don't accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, we'll not be in that resurrection. But thank God we believe this morning. I said, thank God we believe this morning. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
The Bible says, the verse 16, for the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be called up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever, amen, be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. So I'll comfort you this morning, glory to God, that there's going to be a great sale one of these days, praise God, because of the resurrection of Jesus. Amen. Death can't, and hell and the grave can't hold. Well, the hell can, because if you're in hell, you're in trouble. But the death, amen, death and the grave cannot hold a child of God. Thank God this morning, church, we've got a hope this morning, amen, because of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And all those that believe in Jesus Christ and have accepted Jesus Christ, no matter who they are or where they are, they shall, amen, we shall see them again. I'll give a little hand to that, church. I thank God this morning for that resurrection power. I feel that lively spirit within with me, glory to God. But not only that, church, I'm here to tell you something. My hope one day is to be in heaven.
Yes.
My hope, I have a hope this morning. I have a hope that Jesus is coming back. Jesus said in St. John chapter 14, 1 through 3, he tells us, amen, if you believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I would have told you so. But I go away and prepare a place for you, and I will come again, amen, and to receive you unto myself, glory to God. What a hope we have this morning. I'll give it on a hand clap, church. Oh, glory to God. But we have an even better hope than that. The Bible says we shall reign with everlasting joy. Church, we have joy down here. The Bible says the kingdom of God is righteous, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. But church, we haven't seen nothing yet. The Bible says, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has it in the heart of man what God has prepared for them, amen, that love him. Churches, keep on loving God, keep on waiting upon God, because church, he's going to show us something, amen, that I don't even just talk about, and we can just imagine a little bit and say something I don't really imagine. But church, let me tell you something, eyes have not seen, and ears have not entered. We can't hear, and our eyes can't, and our mind can't comprehend what God has prepared for us. But we're going to have eternal life and live with joy forever. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 51, verse 11. Isaiah 51, verse 11. Therefore, the redeemed, are you redeemed this morning by the blood of Jesus Christ? Do you believe in Jesus this morning? Have you accepted the resurrection, the power of the Almighty God? Then you're redeemed. Therefore, the redeemed of the Lord shall return and come with singing unto Zion with everlasting joy, shall be upon their head, and they shall obtain gladness and joy, and sorrow and mourning shall flee away. See, the Isaiah saw, amen, what we're seeing today in the book of Revelation. Thank God we look in the book of Revelation chapter 21. The Bible tells us that we're a child of God. And the Bible says tears shall be wiped away. Heartache shall disappear. Amen. Death shall be disappeared. There'll be no devil up there. This is what I'm saying, church. Oh, you talk about eternal joy. You talk about everlasting joy, church. We may have a little problem down here and go through some hard times down here. But church, it's going to be worth it all. I said it's going to be worth it all when we get to heaven, church. We just got to hang on. And that same power that raised Jesus up from that grave is going to raise us up. And that same power that raised Jesus up and tucked into eternal glory is going to be the same. That same Spirit is going to take us up to heaven. And we're going to be with Jesus. And we're going to reign with glory. And we're going to reign for everlasting joy. Have everlasting peace. And we're going to be the child of God. And church, for thousands and thousands of years, I would say that's some amazing grace. Church, let me tell you something. It's going to be all right up there.
Amen.
I mean, not just for 1,000 years and not for 1,000,000 years, but throughout eternal ages, we'll have an everlasting joy and we'll have an everlasting peace and we're going to reign and be with God forever. Church, it's going to be worth it all. Let's just hang on, believe in that resurrection power, have the hope in Jesus, and know that you have received the power and over all the enemy because of his resurrection power, that you can overcome the devil and all the powers and all the principalities if you just believe in Jesus, hang on to Jesus, and rebuke the devil by faith when he comes at you. I'll give the Lord a hand clap, church. Oh, I'm about to feel this. In closing this morning, the Bible says in Revelation 21, verse 3, and I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he shall dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them, and they and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said unto me, it is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. And I will give unto him that is athirst a fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things and be with God, and he shall be, and be my son. But my Bible goes on in verse 8, said, but not so with the unbelievers. Church, let me tell you something. As sure as God's got a heaven, he's got a hell.
Amen.
Can I say that again? Amen. As sure as God's got a heaven for us, he's got a hell for the unbeliever. That's why we need to believe Jesus. That's why we need to accept Jesus. Because sure as God loves us, and he'll love us till that last breath is taken from us. Don't let nobody tell you that God loves you so much, amen, that he won't send you to hell. God will not send nobody to hell. If you go to hell, you go in the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And everything that God has in store for, because God's love is so great and so tender that He loved us so much He gave His only Son, that we can, praise God, have eternal life. And whosoever comes in shall have eternal life. He will pass nobody away. But church, He gave us a Son that we can believe in that resurrection power, that nobody has to go to a devil's hell, but everybody can go, amen, to heaven. And don't let nobody tell you that, that some is born to go to hell and some is born to go to heaven. When we were born, I believe God put something in us, and I believe he tried everywhere in the world to cause us to return to Him and to believe in Him. But because of the man's hardness of his heart and everything, they have rejected God. And God, therefore, God has no other way or no other choice than let them go where they want to go. We have a choice. The Bible tells us in the book of Deuteronomy, He said, choose you whom this day you will serve. You can serve God and have all the blessings and all the goodness, or you can serve Satan, the unbeliever, and face all the curses. Oh, you listen to what I'm saying. Thank God this morning we've got life in Jesus Christ. How many got life in Jesus this morning? If you're born again, you can have life. And church, we've got some good things awaiting upon us.
Amen.
Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has entered the heart of man what God has, amen, for us. Glory to God.
Amen.
That's what Paul told the Corinthian church in 1 Corinthians. Would you stand this morning? Thank God, I believe this morning the resurrection.